स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं
Let me enter into the sutra. Today we will work on two sutras. Try to understand two sutras. Both of them are actually little subtle and subtlest. Actually, both of them have to be understood together, because one starts in the other. Mahadeva leads us to the deeper level. When vividly aware through some particular sense, keep in the awareness. This is the first sutra. Understand? Mahadeva says, when vividly aware through some particular sense, keep in the awareness. And the second sutra is, at the start of sneezing, during fright, in anxiety, above a chance, flying in battle, in extreme curiosity, all these things are different situations in the life. At the beginning of the hunger, at the end of the hunger, be uninterruptedly aware and liberate yourself. I think Mahadeva is almost concluding his books, means concluding his sutras. Whatever he wants to tell, he is breaking everything. He is opening up. It's actually the concluding part, last part of the book. We have only few more sutras, maybe some 30 or 40. That is why he is almost giving every possible technique. He says, at the start of sneezing, during fright, in anxiety, above a chasm, flying in battle, in extreme curiosity, at the beginning of hunger, at the end of hunger, be uninterruptedly aware and let you realize the truth. These two sutras, first sutra is being aware of conscious voluntary movements. Second sutra is being aware of non-voluntary, involuntary or unconscious movements. He is asking us in the first sutra to be aware of voluntary, conscious things, movements. In the second, involuntary things happens in you suddenly, like explosion. First thing we need to understand, how much we are aware of our activity every day. How much we are aware of our movements every day. If you have some strong experience which you really like, for example, even coming evening for the discourses, if this is strong experience and enjoyment, you will see from the morning you are pushing your day for this sitting. The moment you get out of your bed, you will now start calculating, when will I go and see Swamiji? When am I going to go and sit in the discourse? Oh, still 4-5 hours are waiting. Still 4-5 hours, somehow I have to push. You will be doing things just to pass the time, just to finish the time, or some business dealing is the strong experience. Then you will be just waiting, even now, to go and do that dealing. Whatever you think as a strong experience in your life, you will spend your time to go back to that same experience again and again. All other movements in your day looks very pale, very dull, unimportant. And somehow you want to finish it off. You want to get rid of it. Somehow you want that to pass quickly, as much as possible, as quickly as possible. Let it be done. Let it be finished. But Mahadeva says, that is the first problem. Understand, even if you are quickly passing your time to come to the evening session or listen to these great truths, you are wasting those few moments. Do not push your day. Do not think, let the time pass as early as possible. I have seen. If you know you are going to meet some friend or a person with whom you are really in feeling connected, in love, that night, that evening, from morning you will be just pushing the time. You will be telling yourself, "Arey, quick, arey, watch is not moving. What is happening?" Whenever you want the time to pass quickly, understand you are missing the possibility for enlightenment. Every moment, even waiting, there's a very beautiful sloka in Bhagavata. Gopikas are saying, "Oh Krishna, after some time, waiting for you has become more tasty, more juicy than seeing you." Because when we are waiting, our whole inner space is occupied by you, occupied by your sweet memories. Such a ecstatic being. When we are around you also, sometime, usually the trend of the mind is jumping away from the present moment. So even while we are around you, mind starts going somewhere. But when we are away from you, mind is filled with you. We are filled by you. Actually, if you are aware, even the moments which you are away from the master, expecting, trying to push to go and be with him, even those few moments can become intense meditation. Just how it happened to the gopikas. If you can internalize and be aware, you don't have to push those moments. You don't have to tell, no, let this time go quickly so that I will go and see him. No, you don't have to. People tell me, when they leave, especially when they leave the ashram, or when I leave India, when will I see you again, Swamiji? When will I come back again? I tell them, only two things can happen. Either you are always with me, or you are never have been with me. Either you are always with me, or you never have been with me. Be very clear. By me moving away or you moving away, if you feel there is a distance, you never tasted the master, or you never tasted the divine. There will not be any gap. There will not be any distant. The communion will only get stronger and stronger. It will only become very deeper and deeper. If you see something is missing, understand, till you are in the physical plane, you do not experience the master. Maybe for so many other reasons you may be sitting in front of him, not pure spiritual reason. When it is pure spiritual reason, there is no question of missing. It will be such a strong connection. When you are in front physically, you can see through your eyes. When you are away physically, your inner space can see through your inner eyes. That's all. The inner space will be filled with so much of memory, such a strong, sweet memories, experience and ecstasy. You do not have to bother about the distance. In your life, look, many time, many strong experiences make your whole day waste. Because for that half an hour or 1 hour, you will be sitting and waiting, disrespecting all other movements, disrespecting the 23 and a half hour for the sake of that half an hour experience. It may be being together with some friend, being together with some person or some object or some pleasure or whatever it may be. If you are rushing yourself, if you are pushing your day towards that experience from morning, understand, you are wasting 23 and a half hours, precious moments, for the sake of half an hour, the one experience. Mahadeva says here, when vividly aware, through some particular sense, keep in the awareness. Remember how much time you are aware of life this moment. Do not waste the time by pushing you for the sake of some experience, in search of one same joy, same pleasure. Live every moment intensely. Be every moment in this presence. You will suddenly see every moment miracles are happening. Every moment the internalizing is happening. Every moment new revelations are happening. That is what we say by the word. That is what traditionally they explain by the word. Shiva means auspicious energy continuously flowing with no reason. If you feel Shiva, the auspicious feeling, only in the presence of the master, do not think you experience Shiva. No. The translation of the word Shiva means causeless auspiciousness, reasonless ecstasy. Even if master is a reason, you are not experiencing the real Shiva energy. No. I can be a starter. I can start that in you, but I should not be having the key. I can be a starter, that is okay, but I should not be having the key for that experience. It should be constant in you. That is what we call causeless auspiciousness, reasonless ecstasy. For no reason, the Shivatva, auspiciousness will happen in you only when you live every moment, live everything, whatever is happening, as if this is the last moment. There is not going to be any other moment. There is not going to be next step or breath available to you. You will see, actually, if you understand this moment, this is the last breath, this is the last breathing you are going to be doing, you will be able to do, suddenly you will see the depth of the breathing will increase. It will reach the Muladhara. It will reach all the seven energy centers. Anything you understand, this is the last moment, the depth will increase. I have always seen, the last day of the discourse, there will be heavy crowd. Because they know, today is going to be the last day. If they know Swamiji is here, they okay, if not today, tomorrow. If not tomorrow, day after tomorrow. I have always seen the long programs will be always less crowded. If the same Shiva Sutra, if it is 7 days or 5 days, you will see the whole hall is packed and full. Of course, this time I am speaking for the people, for the sake of people around the world. I want this to be completed so that volumes can come out and it can be useful to the millions of seekers around the world, this knowledge. Usually that is the mentality, mental setup. Only if it is really urgent, emergency, attend that file. Otherwise, let the file be in the back side of the corner, in one corner. The urge should become urgent, then the being will open up. Then the exploration, the seeking will end in finding. Otherwise, it will be just a professional seeking. As I was telling you, some police department seeking.